As part of our latest podcast series to gather insights from executives across the International Islamic Trade Finance Corporation, we're pleased to be joined today by engineer Hani Salem Sonbol, Chief Executive Officer at ITFC, who's here to tell us more about the organization's response to COVID-19 in 2020. Mr. Sonbol, as early as April 2020, we saw the first announcement from ITFC in response to the unfolding COVID-19 pandemic. Can you tell us a bit more about how the organization has supported OIC member countries so far?
Since the beginning of the crisis, we felt that as a group that we need to design a special program to face this pandemic and try to minimize the impact of the implication on member countries as much as we can. As far as ITFC is concerned, was a major contributor to this program. The whole package was $2.3 billion, and ITFC's alone contribution was close to $1 billion out of the $2.3 billion. So this is not only in the area of trade finance, but also we provided a number of trade development activities, capacity building, knowledge building. Also, we provided emergency assistance to meet pressing needs of member countries. The spread of this virus was actually not only hit the economies of member countries very bad. So our concern in the beginning, as I said, in the program, which is it's called the 3R program, in the respond phase where we really wanted to meet, as I said, the pressing needs of member countries. However, we feel that also our role in the recovery phases will be even more beneficial for member countries. We are preparing ourselves now to go to the second phase, knowing that there is a second wave of the virus, but we are well prepared now more than ever to help member countries' economies restart again.
Thank you, Mr. Sonbol. Now, as we look towards a post-COVID economy, how will ITFC's crisis management strategy continue to evolve?
Well, this has to do with two parts. First of all, the external part, which is related to our member countries. As I said in the beginning, we are very much concerned about the sustainability of providing services. But with all the measures that ITFC took since the beginning of this pandemic, this will really help us also go through the second phase of this program, hopefully successful. And what I see that ITFC took all what is required through continuous communications with member countries, knowing exactly what are their pressing needs and what is exactly they need to survive in the first phase. Now we are thinking of how to restart their economies again. And that's why we are working very closely with our partners. We were very close to our partners in the first phase so that we can ensure that to maximize the financial assistance to member countries and also to have a greater impact, because this crisis does require collaborations, cooperations among all the players. One institution cannot do it alone. That's why our first part on the external, I think we did very well and we will do very well. And member countries, they do appreciate a lot what we did in the first phase. Second is the internal measures that we are pressing a lot of emphasis on the governance structure of ITFC. We want to make sure that all measures are taken to ensure control over the portfolios without having any issues with all the risks that comes with such virus or with such crisis. ITFC, in fact, took all the measures, as I said, to protect its portfolio. We have a portfolio management kit. We have started this internally to make sure that we do not face also issues with member countries. And I have to say that, you know, the support of member countries to ITFC was great. I think the member countries, they really consider ITFC as an important partner. And that's why we have never had, since the beginning, despite of the financial difficulties they are going through, an issue with any member countries, especially from the LDMCs, the least developed member countries. They did an extremely extraordinary job by keeping a very good relationship with ITFC during the last part of 9 months of the year. So this will show you how much really ITFC is recognized by member countries. And I feel very, very happy to see that this kind of a relationship serves member countries not only during good times, but also during difficult times.
I'd like to take this opportunity to thank engineer Hani Salem Sonbol for joining us today to shed further light on the tremendous response ITFC has made to OIC member countries throughout 2020 and beyond.